knows a lot about the science stuff. Professor Dave explains.
With macrophages and dendritic cells covered, let's move on to neutrophils. Neutrophils are the most plentiful leukocytes in circulation. They constitute about 60 to 70% of the total white blood cells in human blood, acting as the first line of defense in innate immunity. This cell subtype are the major pathogen-fighting innate immune cells in living organisms, ranging from slime molds to mammals. The key functions of neutrophil-mediated host defense involve movement to the sites of infection and injury, sensing of microbes, phagocytosis, killing or containment of pathogens, and finally, termination of resulting inflammation after pathogen clearance. However, the same neutrophil activation pathways that kill pathogens and intensify inflammation can also cause injury to the host. Therefore, the optimal calibration of neutrophil response is desired in order to defend against pathogens while also avoiding excessive tissue injury. Neutrophils are made within the bone marrow in high numbers. Adult humans produce more than 100 billion neutrophils per day. In the bone marrow, via the process of granulopoiesis, hematopoietic stem cells differentiate into multipotent progenitor cells that cannot self-renew. MPPs transform into lymphoid-primed multipotent progenitors, or LMPPs, which then differentiate into granulocyte-monocyte progenitors, or GMPs. These GMPs, under control of the granulocyte colony-stimulating factor, GCSF, commit to neutrophil generation by turning into myeloblasts. The final steps of neutrophil development proceed through maturation steps of metamyelocytes, band cells, and ultimately mature segmented neutrophils. As neutrophils mature, they develop multiple granules that play a key role in microbicidal activity. Secretory vesicles are small, easily exocytosed organelles that are present only in mature segmented neutrophils. Mature neutrophils have a characteristic granular appearance and are large in size, about 12 to 15 micrometers in diameter. Their nucleus is segmented into 3 to 5 lobules. Studies estimate them to have a short half-life in the blood, on the magnitude of hours rather than days. Mature neutrophils are retained in the bone marrow through the action of two chemokine receptors, CXCR2 and CXCR4. Osteoblasts and other bone marrow stromal cells, or connective tissue cells, produce chemokine CXCL12 and keep CXCR4 expressing neutrophils within the bone marrow. GCSF, a growth factor, promotes neutrophil exit from the bone marrow via CXCR4-CXCL12 interaction. Human blood neutrophils have handed or segmented nuclei, contain heterogeneous cytoplasmic granules, and express MAC1 or CD11b, CD15, CD16 Fc gamma receptor 3, CD33, and CD66b. Additionally, lack of CD14 expression is generally used to distinguish neutrophils from other innate immune cells, such as eosinophils and monocytes. Under homeostatic conditions, neutrophils enter the circulation, migrate to tissues where they complete their functions, and finally are eliminated by macrophages, all in the span of a day. Neutrophils are crucial entities of the innate immune system, which deploy a range of effector functions, such as phagocytosis, degranulation, and the formation of NET, or neutrophil extracellular traps, as a part of their protective function. Phagocytosis is a fundamental method for the effective elimination of pathogens. It enables clearance of not only microbes, but also of dead cells and tissue debris. Essentially, this process is initialized by internalization of targeted organisms or particles. Two mechanisms can lead to target internalization. First, a method in which a trigger mechanism occurs, where discrete signaling initiates formation of plasma membrane protrusions, shaped by actin, that surround nearby material. The second method is a zipper mechanism, in which cell surface receptors sequentially bind to ligands on the target particle, leading to complete engulfment of the particle by the plasma membrane. The essential phagocytic receptors are Fc gamma class receptors, which recognize IgG, the complement receptor 3, or alpha M beta 2 integrin. Receptor activation initiates signaling cascades that remodel lipids in the cell membrane and lead to rearrangement of the actin cytoskeleton in order to extend the cell membrane around the particle. The microbes are ultimately internalized in a vesicle formed around an engulfed particle, known as a phagosome. Degranulation is important for pathogen killing and in modulating immune response during infectious or non-infectious diseases. Neutrophils release granules in a sequential manner. First, tertiary granules are released, such as cathepsin and gelatinase, also known as metalloproteinase, followed by the secondary granules like lactoferrin, alkaline phosphatase, lysozyme, catholicidin, NADPH oxidase, and collagenase. Finally, primary granules are secreted containing the most pro-inflammatory and antimicrobial proteins, such as elastase, MPO, cathepsin G, defensins HNP1, HNP2, and HNP3, and bacterial permeability increasing protein, or BPI. A relatively recently discovered mechanism, formation of neutrophil extracellular traps, or NET, involves the chromatin in neutrophil DNA loosening up to form complexes with numerous granular and cytoplasmic proteins that are subsequently released into the extracellular space. Participating proteins can be histones H1, H2A, H2B, H3, and H4, as xerophilic granules like MPO, elastase, defensins, and cathepsin G. Specific granules such as lactoferrin, alkaline phosphatase, NADPH oxidase, lysozyme, and collagenase, or tertiary granules like gelatinase and cathepsin. The significance and biological function of these nets is to insulate a specific space, thereby increasing accumulation of high concentrations of antimicrobial agents at the site of infection. The end result is immobilization and killing of microbes, thereby preventing them from spreading. Human neutrophils have been shown to express and produce, either in vitro or in vivo, a variety of pro- and anti-inflammatory cytokines, including TNF-alpha, IL-1-beta, IL-1RA, and IL-6, chemokines including CXCL1, CXCL8, CXCL10, CCL2, CCL3, CCL4, and CCL23, colony-stimulating and angiogenic factors, including GCSF and VEGF, TNF family members like TRAIL, FAS-L, and BAF, and growth factors such as HBEGF. This cytokine, chemokine, and growth factor secretion profile confirms that neutrophils are functionally involved in a variety of physiological and pathological processes, such as hematopoiesis, angiogenesis, wound healing, as well as autoimmune and acute inflammatory diseases. Neutrophils have been shown to be present in the microenvironment of many solid tumors. In a tumor microenvironment, multiple factors derived from tumor cells modify the phenotype and function of myeloid cells or leukocytes, such as neutrophils, into phenotypically distinct subpopulations. These factors can be cytokine signals, epigenetic modifications, and other distinct microenvironment factors. Existence of neutrophils polarized to tumor-associated neutrophils, specifically N1 TANs and N2 TANs, phenotypes with anti-tumor and pro-tumor functions respectively, have been well documented in studies with mice. The N1 neutrophils are short-living, highly cytotoxic cells, which show a mature phenotype and high immune-stimulating activity. On the other hand, the N2 neutrophils are long-living, with low cytotoxicity, showing an immature phenotype and high pro-angiogenic, pro-metastatic, and immunosuppressive activity. Furthermore, in human patients, a high TANs number correlates with a poor prognosis. Therapeutic targeting of TANs has been studied by scientists. However, only a few clinical trials have been carried out up to now due to difficulty in suppressing their action for the role they have in the defense against infections and the risk of immunosuppression. Therefore, the use of neutrophils as a part of cancer treatment requires further research. With neutrophils covered, let's move on to still other cell types.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe to my channel for more tutorials. Support me on Patreon so I can keep making content. And as always, feel free to email me, ProfessorDaveExplains@gmail.com.